Let y of x equal to the cube be equal to the cube root of x to the third plus 1. Which of the following is equivalent to y of x? All right, this is going to be fun. So we know that y of x is equal to the cube root of x to the third plus 1. Which of the following is equivalent to y of x? Well, to evaluate y of x, y of x, everywhere where we see an x here, we would just replace it with a y of x. And it's kind of confusing. It might seem a little bit daunting because it's referring to itself, but it should all make sense in the end. So we're going to have something to the third power plus 1. And in this case, that something is y of x. So what's y of x equal to? Well, it's equal to all of this business. So let me write this down. So this is going to be equal to the cube root of, let me give myself some space. So y of x is the cube root of x to the third plus 1. Now we're going to raise that to the third power. I'm going to raise that to the third power plus 1. And so we just have to evaluate this. So what is this going to be? Well, this is going to be the cube root of, well, what we have right over here. If I take the cube root of something, but then I raise it to the third power, this is like raising something to the 1/3 and then raising that to the third. Well, that's just going to give me this thing. This, all of this business right over here is just going to evaluate to x to the third plus 1. Once again, if I just take the cube root of something, of whatever this is, and then raise that to the third power, that's going to be this original something. Or maybe I should put if I take the cube root of a, and if I raise it to the third power, that's just going to be a here. And that's all I did right over here. The cube root of x to the third plus 1 to the third power is just going to be x to the third plus 1. And then now we have the plus 1. So this is going to be equal to the cube root of x to the third plus 2, which is that choice right over there.